Hi guys, David and David here from payitforward.com, and in this video we're going to tell you what to do when your iPhone speaker is not working.
And this is one of the most common problems that happens when you're attacking the Apple store. And most of the time, people come in with a problem and they assume that there's something wrong with the actual hardware of their iPhone. But that is not necessarily the case, so don't just assume that there's something wrong with your speaker and you need to have it replaced. So you need to know how this all works. The first thing that happens whenever your iPhone plays a sound is the software has to register that that's happening. The software is like the brains of the operation. And then if the software says play the sound, then a signal gets sent to the hardware itself, the hardware plays the sound. So the software is what we always troubleshoot first, especially in the Apple store, because the software, you can probably fix that at home. I'm sure that you can if you follow the instructions that we're gonna go through. If it does turn out to be a hardware problem, then you may have to have your iPhone repaired. But if you go to an Apple store, I guarantee you what they'll do is they'll try to fix the software first, and then they'll get to the hardware stuff. So it doesn't make any sense for you not to do that.
Totally.
And that's probably when you're watching this video. So the first step, and you know what we always check, and this happens all the time, is to check the silent ring switch, just to make sure that it's flipped to the front position. So if you see orange, it's in the silent position. Pull it toward the front of your iPhone.
Pull towards the screen, and then...
Especially if you have a case on your iPhone. So a lot of people have these big, bulky cases. They may not even know that there was a switch in there.
Pretty much every single time I put my case on my iPhone, the ring silent switch gets repositioned. Every single time.
So it's important to make sure that that's, you know, pull that forward, try playing a sound again. If that doesn't work, we're going to move on to the next step. Make sure the volume is all the way up in your iPhone.
That's pretty easy to do. Just press that volume up button. You can hold it down, it'll zip right up, and as you can see, volume is now all the way up on my iPhone.
And so let's also just demonstrate what it could say if something's wrong. If you're doing this, and it says headphones instead of volume, then your iPhone is stuck in headphones mode. And that's a separate issue that we have a separate video for.
And so we'll link to that below in the description.
And if you are seeing headphones right there and it's stuck and the volume slider isn't working, go watch that video, you're done with us here. So, moving on to the next step. After you've made sure that your iPhone is not stuck in headphones mode, we need to make sure that the sound on your iPhone isn't playing somewhere else, and this happens all the time. So if you have a Bluetooth headset and you use it in the car, let's say, your iPhone could be connected to the headset even if you're in the house. Similarly, if you have a Bluetooth speaker, if you're using Apple TV, could be playing there. Anywhere your iPhone is connected wirelessly, it could be sending the sound there. And if the volume is down on your TV, let's say, and you have an Apple TV, you wouldn't hear it.
All right.
So make sure that your iPhone is disconnected from all external devices.
Well, let's check real quick.
The easiest way to do it is to swipe up from the very bottom of the screen to open Control Center.
If you have an iPhone 10, you can swipe down from the upper right-hand corner of the screen.
Then press and hold on Music. And then in the upper right-hand corner of this little window, you'll see the AirPlay
button. It looks like a triangle and the three little circles.
Concentric circles. Tap on that. And that'll give you a list of places where you can play sound from your iPhone.
And as you can see, there's no check mark next to Apple TV or David's Apple TV, so sound is not playing from there. It's only coming from my iPhone right now.
And make sure that iPhone is selected there. Just tap on that, and then go ahead and try to play sound again. So after that happens, if your iPhone is still not playing sound... The speaker's still not working. The volume's all the way up. Headphones aren't connected. It's time to restore your iPhone. And restoring your iPhone takes all the software off of your iPhone and puts it back on. And there's a special type of restore that we recommend.
DFU Restore, we have a great video on that. We'll link it to it below. But we'd recommend backing up your iPhone before you do a DFU Restore just so you don't lose
everything. Every time you restore your iPhone, you lose all of your data. And the DFU Restore is important to do in this case. The DF, the F in that, stands for firmware. And the firmware is what can cause this problem, because firmware is sort of the software that lives in between the software and the hardware. So in between soft and hard is firm. And
there you go.
We got to do the device firmware update, which is the DFU Restore.
And check out that video, we'll link below in the description. So we've done the DFU Restore, speaker is still not working iPhone. What do I do now?
Time to get it repaired. If your iPhone is under warranty, go to the Apple Store. It's probably something that they can fix. I don't want to say for free, because if it is damaged in any way, if there's liquid damage, which is a common issue that causes this problem, it may not be covered. But especially if your iPhone's under warranty or if you have Apple Care Plus, it's always a good idea to go there.
And if Apple isn't going to help you out,
try Pulse. We really like Pulse. They're an on-demand iPhone repair service.
They'll come to you, home or office, fix your iPhone, send someone to you in less than 60 minutes sometimes, which is
cheaper than Apple,
yep.
lifetime warranty, which is better than Apple's warranty, mm-hmm. and they do great work. So generally, we recommend sticking with the bigger establishments mm-hmm. because they guarantee their work in a way that the smaller stores usually right. can't.
So that is what to do when your mm-hmm. iPhone speaker is not working. Thank you guys for watching this video. Leave a comment down below if you have any other questions, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more iPhone videos.